The nuclear weapons disposal facility on Shadow Moses Island in Alaska's Fox Archipelago was attacked and captured by next-generation special forces being led by members of Foxhound. They are demanding that the government turn over the remains of Big Boss, and they say that if their demands are not met within 24 hours, they'll launch a nuclear weapon. You will have two mission objectives. First, you're to rescue DARPA Chief Donald Anderson and the President of ArmsTech, Kenneth Baker. Both are being held as hostages. Secondly, you're to investigate whether or not the terrorists have the ability to make a nuclear strike and stop them if they do.
What's the insertion method?
We'll approach the disposal facility by sub.
And then?
We'll launch a one-man SDV. SDV gets as close as it can. Dispose of it. From there on, you'll have to swim. High-tech Special Forces Unit Foxhound, your former unit, and one that I was the commander of.
So they're still around.
There are six members of Foxhound involved in this terrorist activity. Psycho Mantis, with his powerful psychic abilities. Sniper Wolf, the beautiful and deadly sharpshooter. Decoy Octopus, master of disguise. Vulcan Raven, giant and shaman. And Revolver Ocelot, specialist in interrogation and a formidable gunfighter. And finally, in charge of them, Foxhound squad leader, Liquid Snake.
Liquid Snake?
Weapons disposal facility covers the whole island. I'll instruct you by codec after you reach your target.
Anyone going with me?
As always, this is a one-man sneaking mission.
Weapons and equipment OSP.
Yes. This is a top secret black op. Don't expect any official support.
Stay alert. He'll be through here.
I know it.
I'm going to swat down a couple of bothersome flies.
Thank you. This is Snake. Colonel, can you hear me?
Loud and clear. What's the situation, Snake?
Looks like the elevator in the back is the only way up.
Just as I expected. You'll have to take the elevator to the surface, but make sure nobody sees you.
Front of the disposal facility.
Excellent, Snake. Age hasn't slowed you down one bit.
How's that sneaking suit working out?
I'm nice and dry, but it's a little hard to move.
Bear with it. It's designed to prevent hypothermia. This is Alaska, you know.
Take it easy. I'm grateful. If it weren't for your suit and your shot, I would have turned into a popsicle out there.
An anti-freezing peptide, Snake. All of the genome soldiers in this exercise are using it.
I see. I'm relieved to hear that. Already tested, huh? By the way, how's the diversionary operation going?
Two F-16s just took off from Galena and are headed your way. The terrorist radar should have already picked them up.
A Hind D. Colonel, what's a Russian gunship doing here?
I have no idea. But it looks like our little diversion got their attention. Now's your best chance to slip in unnoticed. If you want to get in, there's the front door. It's the fastest way, but there's too much risk of being spotted by the enemy.
Yeah, I can't just knock on the door and ask them to let me in.
What about the air duct near the door?
One sentry on the left and one on the right. They're armed with 5.56ers and pineapples.
There should also be a duct on the second floor.
I can't see it from here.
I'll let you decide the best COA. I'm counting on you, Snake.
I moved the DARPA chief to the cell in the first floor basement.
What about the vent shaft cleaning?
Oh, they just opened the vent covers. They're about to start spraying for rats.
First floor basement ventilation shaft.
Shut those covers as soon as they're done spraying. Also, keep your eye on that woman in the cell. Don't get careless now.
Woman in the cell?
Did something happen?
There's an intruder.
Really?
He's already done three people.
He's killed three people?
Yeah, and they say he's using stealth, too.
Stealth? There's an intruder besides me?
Anyway, I want you to increase the security detail on the chief.
that?
I'm here to save you. You're the DARPA chief, Donald Anderson, right?
You're here to save me, huh? What's your outfit?
I'm the pawn they sent in here to save your worthless butt.
Really? It's true. You don't look like one of them. In that case, hurry up and get me out of here.
Slow down. Don't worry. First, I want some information about the terrorists.
The terrorists?
Do they really have the ability to launch a nuke?
What are you talking about?
The terrorists are threatening the White House. They say if they don't accede to their demands, they'll launch a nuclear weapon.
Sweet Jesus.
Is it possible?
It's possible. They could launch a nuke.
How do they plan to launch? I thought this place was just for the keeping of dismantled warheads. They shouldn't have access to a missile.
That's the official story. Got it? We were conducting exercises with a new type of experimental weapon. A truly historical weapon.
What?
A weapon with the ability to launch a nuclear attack from any place on the face of the Earth. A nuclear-equipped walking battle tank. If it hadn't been for the revolution.
Revolution?
Rex has fallen into the hands of terrorists.
Rex?
Metal Gear Rex, the code name for the new Metal Gear prototype. They're probably already finished arming the warhead they plan to use with Rex. These guys are pros. They're all experienced in handling and equipping nuclear weapons.
Hey! Shut up in there, will ya?
I thought that all nuclear warheads were equipped with safety measures. Some kind of detonation code that you have to input.
Oh, you mean PAL. Yes, of course. There is a PAL. It's set up so that you need to input two different passwords in order to launch the device.
There are two passwords?
Yes. Baker knows one, and I know one.
Baker, the president of Arms Tech?
That's right. Each of us needs to input our password. Or there can be no launch. But... they found out my password.
You talked?
Psycho Mantis can read people's minds. You can't resist.
Psycho Mantis?
One of the members of Foxhound. He has psychic powers.
This is bad.
It's just a matter of time before they get Baker's too.
If they find out Baker's password...
Yes. They'll be able to launch a nuke anytime. But there is a way to stop the launch.
What?
The card keys.
Card keys?
They were designed by Arms Tech. The system developers has an emergency override. Even without the passwords, you can just insert the card keys and engage the safety lock.
And if I do that?
Yes, you can stop the launch.
That card key.
So where are the card keys?
Baker should have them. Listen, You need 3 card keys. There are 3 different slots to put them in. You need to insert a card into each one of them.
Okay, 3 card keys. Do you know where they might be keeping Baker?
Somewhere in the second floor basement.
Second floor basement?
I heard the guards say they moved him into an area that has a lot of electronic jamming.
Any other clues?
Yes. Here, take this.
Okay, I'm gonna get you out of here.
Wait a minute.
What is it?
You haven't heard any other way to disarm the PAL, have you? From your bosses or anyone?
No.
Are you sure you haven't heard anything?
I just said no.
So, does the White House plan to give in to the terrorists' demands?
That's their problem. It has nothing to do with my orders.
But what about the Pentagon?
Pentagon? What is it?
The chief, you bastard! Liquid? No, you're not. Don't move!
Is this the first time you ever pointed a gun at a person? Your hands are shaking.
Careful. I'm no rookie.
Liar. Your eyes wander. There's no confidence in them. The eyes of a rookie. You've never shot a person, have you?
You talk too much.
You haven't even taken the safety off, rookie.
I told you I'm no rookie.
You're not one of them, are you?
Open that door. You've got a card, don't you?
Why?
So we can get the hell out
of
here.
Looks like we'll be a little delayed. What are you doing? Don't think! Shoot!
Thanks for the help.
Wait! Who are you?
Thank you.
too late? He's alive. You're the Armstech president, Kenneth Baker, right? Don't worry. I'm here to save you.
No! Don't touch it!
C4!
Right. Touch that wire and the C4 will blow up along with the old man. So you're the one that the boss keeps talking about.
And you?
Special Operations Foxhound. Revolver. Ocelot. I've been waiting for you, Solid Snake. Now we'll see if the man can live up to the legend. This is the greatest handgun ever made. The Colt Single Action Army. 6 bullets. More than enough to kill anything that moves. Now I'll show you why they call me Revolver. Draw! You're pretty good. Just what I'd expect from the man with the same code as the boss. It's been a long time since I had such a good fight, but I'm just getting warmed up. Stealth camouflage! Can't you even die right? You were lucky! We'll meet again! Who are you?
That exoskeleton.
The DARPA chief told me he gave them his detonation code. What about yours?
Oh, I get it. Jim sent you. You're from the Pentagon.
Answer my question. What about your code? There's no time.
I talked.
What? Now the terrorists have both codes and can launch any time.
It's not like I didn't fight. I managed to resist Psycho Mantis' mind probe.
He couldn't read you? How'd you do it?
Surgical implants in my brain.
Surgical implants?
Kinda like psychic insulation. Everyone who knows these top secret codes has it.
Even the DARPA chief?
Of course.
But the DARPA chief said Mantis got his code by reading his mind.
Are you sure you heard him right?
Yeah.
So, the DARPA chief, is he okay?
Dead.
What? It can't be. No, that's not what you promised, Jim! Now you want to shut me up! Ah.
Calm down. What's wrong with you? I just told you I was here to save you. I didn't kill the DARPA chief. He had a heart attack or something.
A heart attack? Oh, don't be a fool.
Anyway, the terrorists have both codes now.
Oh, those boys are totally insane. They wouldn't hesitate to launch.
I agree. But what do they really want?
Who knows? Maybe they're like us in the arms industry. Always looking forward to the next good war.
Well, I'm not gonna let these maniacs start a war today. Do you still have the card keys?
Card keys?
To override the detonation code. I heard you had them.
No, not anymore.
What? Who does then? Not the terrorists.
No, that woman.
Woman? Who?
A soldier that was thrown in prison along with me.
Prison? That female soldier?
She said that she had just joined up as a new recruit. They threw her in prison because she refused to take part in the rebellion.
A new recruit? Could that be the colonel's niece?
I gave her the key. Looks like she managed to break out of here, though. I hope she's okay.
I'm sure she is. She's green, but as tough as they come.
But how did you know she escaped?
I was in contact with her by codec. Until I was tied up here, that is.
Codec?
Here. This is what you came for, right?
What's that?
An optical disc. It's all here. The main hard drive was destroyed by gunfire. This is the only remaining copy of the data.
What kind of data?
All the data collected from this exercise. Don't play dumb. I know you were sent to get this. I hid it from that sadistic maniac while he was torturing me. They don't know this disc exists. Make sure that you report this to Jim, to your boss. I'll give you my card, too. It'll open up all security level 2 doors.
Can you walk?
No. You go on without me. Oh. They got my password. They don't want anything else from me.
I have one more question. Who or what was that ninja thing? It looked like you knew something.
That ninja? That was Foxhound's dark little secret.
Dark little secret?
An experimental genome soldier.
You know him?
You should ask Dr. Naomi Hunter from Foxhound. She knows better than I.
Naomi?
You've got to stop them. If it goes public, my company and I are finished.
What? Doesn't Metal Gear use currently existing technology?
Metal Gear itself does, but... Oh, what? What did you do to me? No, it can't be those Pentagon bastards. So they actually went and did it.
What are you talking about?
They're just using you for
what the hell?
Territory. Snakes don't belong in Alaska. I will not let you pass. Send him a message. That's right. You belong on the ground. You should crawl on the ground like the snake you are. Come, let's fight!
Boss, is this all right? Just giving him the card like that.
We'll play with him a little longer.
Stealth camouflage? Who are you?
Where is my friend?
What? What are you talking about? What next?
Snake!
Hey, you're that ninja.
I've been waiting for you, Snake.
Who are you?
Neither enemy nor friend. I am back from a world where such words are meaningless. I've removed all obstacles. Now you and I will battle to the death.
What do you want?
Oh, I've waited a long time for this day. Now I want to enjoy this moment.
What's with these guys? It's like one of my Japanese animes.
I've come from another world to battle with you.
What is it? Revenge?
It is nothing so trivial as revenge. A fight to the death with you. Only in that can my soul find respite. I will kill you, or you will kill me. It makes no difference. All right then. Watch from your box seat.
I need that man. Keep your hands off him.
Now, make me feel it. Make me feel alive again.
Ah!
felt that, Snake? Do you remember me now?
It can't be. You were killed in Zanzibar. That ninja is Gray Fox. No doubt about it.
Ridiculous. You yourself, in Zanzibar land.
Yes. He should have been killed, but he's still alive.
What?
It happened before I joined Foxhound's medical staff. They were using a soldier for their gene therapy experiments.
I never heard that.
It happened right after you retired. My predecessor, Dr. Clark, was in charge.
Dr. Clark?
Yes. He started the gene therapy project.
And where is he now?
He was killed in an explosion in his lab 2 years ago.
So what about this soldier?
Apparently, for their test subject, they decided to use the body of a soldier who was recovered after the fall of Zanzibar land.
And that was Gray Fox?
But he was already dead.
Yes. But they revived him. They fitted him with a prototype exoskeleton and kept him drugged for 4 years while they experimented on him like a plaything. Today's genome soldiers were born from those experiments.
That's the sickest thing I've ever heard.
They used him to test all sorts of gene therapy techniques.
Naomi, why didn't you tell us about this sooner?
Because it's confidential information.
Is that the only reason? How long are you gonna stay in there?
Huh? Are you one of them?
No, I'm not. I always work alone.
Alone? Are you an otaku too?
Come on, get out. We can't stay here forever.
Your uniform's different from theirs.
You're the Metal Gear Rex chief engineer, Hal Emmerich, right?
You know me?
I heard about you from Merrill.
Oh. So you're here to rescue me?
Sorry, but no. There's something that I've got to do first.
Oh. Well, at least you're not one of them.
Are you hurt?
I'm okay. I just twisted my ankle a little trying to get away.
Well, if that's all, it's nothing to worry about. I want to ask you something. I need information about Metal Gear.
Huh? Metal Gear?
Yeah. What's Metal Gear really designed for?
It's a mobile TMD. It's designed to shoot down nuclear missiles. Only for defensive purposes, of course.
Liar! I already know that Metal Gear is nothing but a nuclear-equipped walking deathmobile.
Nuclear? What are you talking about?
The terrorists are planning to use Metal Gear to launch a nuclear missile. You telling me you didn't know?
Aren't they just trying to use the TMD missile module to launch a disabled nuclear warhead?
Wrong. From the beginning, the purpose of this exercise was to test Metal Gear's nuclear launch capability using a dummy nuclear warhead. The terrorists are just continuing the work you started.
No, you're wrong.
I heard it directly from your boss, Baker.
No. A nuclear missile on Rex?
So you really didn't know?
The truth is, my grandfather was part of the Manhattan Project. He suffered with the guilt for the rest of his life. And my father? He was born on August 6th, 1945.
The day of the Hiroshima bomb. God's got a sense of humor, all right.
3 generations of Emmerich men. We must have the curse of nuclear weapons written into our DNA. I used to think that I could use science to help mankind. But in the end, I was the one being used. Using science for peace? That's only in anime.
That's enough crying. Pull yourself together. Where is Metal Gear? Where on this base are they keeping it?
Rex is in the underground maintenance base.
Where's that?
North of the communications tower. But it's a long way there.
The emergency override system for the detonation code is there too?
Yeah, in the base's control room. You'd better hurry. If they were planning a launch from the start, then their ballistic program is probably finished. And since they haven't called for me in a few hours, they must not need me. In other words, they must be ready to launch.
Meryl's got the detonation code override keys. We'll link up with her.
If we can't override the launch, we'll have to destroy Rex.
Here, use this security card. It's security level 4.
You're not in pain, are you?
Huh?
You feel okay? Nothing bothering you?
What's wrong? You're all friendly all of a sudden.
No, nothing. Just glad you're okay.
You're strange.
I'm a little nervous. Everyone else I've saved suddenly dies.
You're bad luck.
Forget it, Doctor.
Call me Otacon.
Otacon?
It stands for Otaku Convention. An otaku is a guy like me who likes Japanimation. Japan was the first country to successfully make bipedal robots. They're still the best in the field of robotics.
And Japanese cartoons played some part in that?
They did. I didn't get into science to make nuclear weapons, you know.
Yeah, that's what all scientists say.
I became a scientist because I wanted to make robots like the ones in the Japanese animes. Really, it's true.
Sounds like an excuse to me.
You're right. We have to take responsibility. Science has progressed because there is war. And because of scientists' greed, weapons of mass destruction were born. But that's all over. I won't take part in murder anymore.
Whatever. All I want from you is information.
Sure. I know everything about this whole base. Ask me anything about Rex or about this place. I'm on frequency 141.12. See you later.
Don't move. That's the second time I've been able to sneak up on the legendary Solid Snake.
You're Meryl. There's no way you could pass for a man for long.
What do you mean? Hey, men aren't allowed in here.
I had no idea you were so feminine.
This is no time to try and hit on me, Snake.
So why'd you change? You'd be a lot better off dressed like one of them.
I got tired of disguising myself. The truth is, the uniform smelled like blood.
What's that mark?
Huh? Oh, this? It's a paint tattoo. It's not real. I'm a fan of Foxhound way back, when guys like you and my uncle were in it. None of that gene therapy like there is today. You guys were real heroes.
There are no heroes in war. All the heroes I know are either dead or in prison. One or the other.
But Snake, you're a hero, aren't you?
I'm just a guy who can only find meaning on the battlefield. There's no winning or losing for a mercenary. The only winners in war are the people.
That's right. And you fight for the people.
I've never fought for anyone but myself. I've got no purpose in life. No ultimate goal.
Come on.
It's only when I'm cheating death on the battlefield, the only time I feel truly alive.
Seeing other people die makes you feel alive, huh? You can't stop loving war. Is it the same for all soldiers throughout history? So, Snake, how are the negotiations going?
No progress.
So it's all up to you, huh?
Somebody's gotta stop them from launching a nuclear missile.
There are two ways. Either we destroy Metal Gear, or...
we override the detonation code. You got the card keys from Baker?
Card keys? You mean this?
Where are the others? There should be three keys.
This is all I've got.
Where could the other two be?
I have no idea, but they must be somewhere. If we can't find them, we'll have no choice but to destroy Metal Gear.
I heard that Metal Gear is in an underground maintenance base to the north of here.
Take me too. I know this place better than you do.
You'll just slow me down. You don't have enough battle experience.
I won't slow you down. I promise.
And what if you do?
Then you can shoot me.
I don't like to waste bullets.
Okay, let's go. I know this place better than you. I'll be point man. Follow me. That's strange. There's no guard.
What happened to the music?
I'll keep a lookout. Make sure you're ready, okay? Okay, let's go. Come on, Mr. Foxhound. The commander is waiting.
Ah!
the...
Do you like me? Hold me, Snake.
What's wrong?
Hurry. Please, make love to me.
It's not your only trick.
You doubt my power. Now, I will show you why I am the most powerful practitioner of psychokinesis and telepathy in the world. No, there's no need for words, Snake. I am Psychomantis. That's right. This is no trick. It's true power. It's useless. I told you, I can read your every thought.
He makes his own.
I can read people's minds. In my lifetime, I have read the pasts, presents, and futures of thousands upon thousands of men and women.
Oh, gross.
And each mind that I peered into was stuffed with the same single object of obsession. That selfish and atavistic desire to pass on one seed. It was enough to make me sick. Every living thing on this planet exists to mindlessly pass on their DNA. We're designed that way. And that is why there is war. The first person whose mind I dove into was my father's. I saw nothing but disgust and hatred for me in his heart. My mother died in childbirth, and he despised me for it. I thought my father was going to kill me. when my future disappeared. I lost my past as well. When I came to, the village was engulfed in flames.
Are you saying that you burned your village down to bury your past?
I see that you have suffered the same trauma. We are truly the same, you and I. The world is a more interesting place with people like you in it. I never agreed with the boss's revolution. His dreams of world conquest do not interest me. I just want an excuse to kill as many people as I could.
You monster.
Let him talk. He doesn't have much time left.
I've seen true evil, Snake. Seeing you calms my soul. You're like the boss. No, worse. Compared to you, I'm like a saint.
Let's go, Meryl. Meryl.
Meaningless without a war. Snake, please, save yourself. Go on living and don't give up on people. Don't forget me. Don't forget what I said. Now, get out of here.
Meryl!
Colonel?
Damn! Snake! It's a trap. A sniper's trick to lure you out. The sniper's waiting for you to go to help Meryl so he can pick you off. Don't do it!
It must be Sniper Wolf, Foxhound's best shooter.
Snipers usually work in pairs, but this one's alone, huh?
I know her. She can wait for hours, days, or weeks. Doesn't matter to her. She's just watching and waiting for you to expose yourself.
Maybe so, but Meryl can't hold out that long.
Snake, can you see Wolf from where you are?
There's nowhere to hide between here and the tower. She must be on the second floor of the tower.
If Wolf is in the communications tower, she can see you perfectly. It's a classic sniper's position. At that distance, you won't be able to hit her with a standard weapon either. You'll need a sniper rifle.
Colonel, take it easy. I'm going to save Meryl, no matter what it takes.
Okay. Thanks.
I can still help. I want to help you.
Quiet down. Save your strength.
I was a fool. I wanted to be a soldier. Don't forget me.
Snake, about Meryl.
Colonel, I'm sorry.
Snake, she's a soldier. She knows that prisoners are a part of war. She joined up of her own free will. I'm sure she was prepared for this.
No, you're wrong. Meryl thought she had to become a soldier. Thought it was the only way. She said she thought it would bring her closer to her dead father.
She said that?
She wasn't ready for real combat. I shouldn't have pushed her so hard. It's all my fault.
That's not like you, Snake.
Master? What is it?
Sorry for eavesdropping, but I couldn't just listen anymore.
Master?
Snake, you can have regrets if you want to. It's only natural. But you can't keep attacking yourself for things that happened in the past. Nothing good will come from that.
He's right. Don't kick yourself. It doesn't suit a legend like you.
Snake, forget about Meryl. Stop Liquid. That's what Meryl would want, too.
You're right. Meryl would say the same thing.
Snake.
What?
Meryl. She's pretty special to you, huh?
Well, yeah, special. There aren't many tomboys like her.
That's not what I meant.
She's the Colonel's niece and a combat buddy.
Is that all? Come on.
This is like a police interrogation.
No, I just...
I guess it's in the genes.
The genes? What are you talking about, Colonel?
No, I just remembered about Naomi's grandfather. I think Naomi said he rose as high as assistant secretary in the FBI during Edgar Hoover's time.
Is that right?
Yes. Yes. He was Japanese, and he became a special undercover investigator to nab the Mafia.
When was that?
Sometime in the 50s, I guess.
Where?
New York, I think.
Oh.
Snake. Good luck.
Watch your back, Snake.
Don't move!
Oh.
to miss when you're this close. Toss your weapon over here. Slowly. You're a fool to come back here. Stupid man.
A lady sniper, huh?
Don't you know that the majority of the world's great assassins are women? Do you want to die now? Or after your female friend? Which will it be?
I'll die after I kill you.
Is that right? Well, at least you've got spirit. I am Sniper Wolf, and I always kill what I aim at. You are my special prey. Got it? I've left my mark on you. I won't forget it. Until I kill you, you're all I'll think about.
Take him away!
Don't kill him yet. I want him alive.
Leave it to me.
I want no more accidents like that DARPA chief.
Yes, he's my target. Mine alone.